Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the last part of Play to Find Out Magic Dance. A storm just started here, so that's something.
Exciting.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thunder just happened right as I brought us back in.
Perfect.
So hopefully it's a regular storm and not too bad. That'll kick us off.
Hopefully. That would really suck.
That would be the worst ending to a show ever.
I know.
Powers out.
Okay, and... so I need to make a desperate...
No! we come back in. We see you guys, like, ejecting that weird chunk of the balanced breakfast that you pulled with you, and see that, like, in the fog of this outcoming is, like, kind of sweeping out of that hole in the other ship. And you guys are all, nobody else is still on the ship. You guys are all in the magic dance. But what do you guys do?
Bishop.
So, Ophi wants to help Bishop and
Vi
to get GTFO.
Would that be a setup action?
I don't know if it'd be a setup action or if I just spend a stress to give you an extra die.
Yeah, whichever you want to do.
I mean, I'll just have to spend a stress then.
Okay, sure.
Thing.
I got an extra.
Yeah, so you're mathing with Vi. As
yeah, like, I mean, Ophi's bringing over all of, like, the 20 years of data,
right? So yeah,
they can see, okay, here's where everything has been for the last 20 years, where it's not adding up correctly. But if we analyze it, like, out for those 20 years, can we see a correlation that maybe we could use as a basis for our translation? As either assistance with helping Bishop figure out what the speed of light in a vacuum is, or some other.
Would this be considered a speed related role? I don't think it is.
Yeah, I don't think it's speed, because really you're just trying to figure out the calculations. Because really, what you're trying to do is jump back into a warp tunnel that you're not entering through a gate, which, you know, is theoretically kind of impossible, but, you know.
But the trick is we're not in real space.
Right, yeah, that's so, the thing. Like, all of this is super weird, so, like, you're kind of...
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's fine. I'll just use that to get money.
Yeah, yeah. So we see, we see, like, the big group of you, like, Tony, Pork, Bishop, Ophi, and Vi, all just, like, hunched around, like, the bridge computer, calculating weird math, and then, like, reprogramming it to the ship's systems. Like, basically, everyone has a terminal, and everyone's just doing weird typing and shit. I think Flora and OJ are just, like,
They're just playing bloody knuckles in the corner.
Right, yeah, there's nothing they can do about it. And so them and Zoinks are just in the corner, like, are just, like, I think Flora pulls out, like, some sort of alcohol or something. And it's, like, OJ and her are just...
They start playing poker.
Right, yeah, they're just doing something in the corner because they can't help with this at all. And yeah, Zoinks, them and Zoinks are over there.
So I have maps and charts, correct? Like, on my character sheet, I have that.
Okay.
So Bishop has a theory that Bishop would like to attempt.
Sure.
Bishop gets up on, like, the, like, whiteboard or whatever that we have and just, like, starts drawing. He's like, so the way I figure, we're in a, basically in an eddy of the river of space and time.
So you're not at the controls to fly the ship?
I'm doing an explanation.
So as you're explaining something, you hear incoming missiles.
I think that's the problem.
I get on the controls.
Okay. You see that the balanced breakfast is now flying at you and is firing its weapons.
Ghost fight!
The ghosts have taken over the ship.
Well, looks like we're doing this without any... theories, and then he just hits jump.
Okay.
He's just like, here we go, jump.
Oh, Okay. So.
This sounds like a. This is a desperate roll.
It is. It is desperate.
So Bishop just sees this and he's like, gas, power, jump.
Yep. Yeah. So this is
as fast as he can do it together.
So this is definitely desperate.
Can I do one thing before he does this?
Sure.
I'll, like, force bubble myself just in case.
Okay. Yeah. You're just like, oh.
It's not scrap. It's helm. Okay. Hold
okay.
On
so yeah, you're desperate, and I'm gonna
I
say
grab our captain too. I'm saving you, Kelsey.
Desperate.
Well, because of all your bonus, because of all your bonuses for effect, like with Vi and everything, I think you're gonna be at great. So you're at desperate great right now.
Desperate great. I gain potency on speed related rolls.
Right, yeah, so we figured out can you go above great? I forget.
You can go to extreme.
Okay.
Which is basically like if you succeed you crit.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, so you're desperate extreme.
Desperate extreme. I have a bonus dice for Vi.
Mm-hmm.
A bonus dice because I'm pushing myself.
Spend a gambit.
A bonus die for Ophi. Yeah, spend a gambit.
But for Ophi, it's spending a gambit.
Okay. Yeah. So is that four extra die?
Four extra die.
Okay.
Do I get any die for these people helping me? Can NPCs help?
Not. I think their help is just factoring into all of this extra stuff.
Okay. So I am going to... it's push or accept the devil's bargain. So I'm just going to push.
Myself. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I was going to ask if I could take a devil's bargain. So I take three stress because I want to get my, actually extra effect doesn't help me here. So it's just two.
Okay.
Four bonus die.
Okay.
Oh, the lag. All the lag. All the lag. All the lag. All the lag. No. I can't see it. What did it do?
We can't see it either.
That was the thunder outside.
Oh, bunch of fives.
Fives.
Again with all the fives.
Yep.
That's a lot of fives.
Okay.
But
I
love that. I love that.
But
this fuck. Is amazing.
So, fuck. You just pound the go button without, like, doing a final explanation, without, like, doing a last check of your math, without, like, making, like, okay, is everybody, like, tied down and good? You just hit go.
And I'm probably not even in my seatbelt.
And, like, yeah, like, your ship just rockets off, and then, like, we see the missiles kind of, like, trailing behind you, but, like, they, like... You're boosting off so much that, like, they get, like, messed up. The Brainless Breakfast, the entire ship gets surrounded by this mist. And, it vanishes.
Now it's a real ghost ship.
So we see you guys just like
roll to end the game on. Can we just
so we see you guys
that?
Like yeah, you're like firing through, like aiming for like kind of where you left the tunnel. Vi says, like as you guys are going and like you're kind of like at speed. So basically, Vi says, we need something to trigger the alteration into warp space. She says something, and basically in our terms, you're going 88 miles per hour, but you need a flux capacitor. And when
that,
she's
is that our consequence?
Well, that's part of it. She says that, and then the ship goes, whoosh, and, like, the scanners just start going weird. Well, not the scanners, like, the like, basically whatever tells you your ship's being attacked, like,
goes
wonky, and just starts spouting off data because it doesn't know what is hitting you.
I'm going to roll to resist.
Okay.
What and how?
So there are two separate things. There's we are being attacked by something.
And there's another portion of this that you need to, like, you need something to, like, be a catalyst for you to jump back into that tunnel, basically.
Ooh, can I do that with the way?
You can. Maybe. Basically, that's yeah. You resisting. You would be the living lightning rod.
I mean, I yeah, you can just lightning. Jump in with resolve and be like, I got this.
I got this.
As so I, let's resolve the thing trying to kill us first.
Okay.
I think it's literally just Bishop, like, sees the alarms and then does some type of crazy evasive maneuver that, like, through, like, crazy head math, all comes out to zero.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I'm going to do some crazy over-the-top maneuver that's going to, in the end, all of our momentum is going to settle out to zero before we hit this thing.
Right, yeah.
So basically, so I love this idea of, like, the whole plan is, like, we're heading towards this tunnel, and the plan is that the break in the tunnel, whatever, the plan is at the exact moment that we hit it, we dead stop. Like...
Right, it's just a whole crazy thing.
No, I totally understand. Uh-huh.
Exactly.
Sorry.
So do I roll helm here? I feel like
Resisting.
I'm resisting the attack, and I feel like the best way to do that is with my prowess, just because I'm good at shit.
Sure. Yeah, because you're trying to steer the ship out of the way. Like your ship got jostled, and now you're just trying to dodge
and
it.
I get
so,
plus 1d, so I'm on 4 dice. Or wait, I don't have 4 bonus die. I have 1 extra die.
Right. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. That's very. Yeah.
4 6. Hey, there you go.
There you go. No stress.
So Bishop just.
Yeah, Bishop, you guys pull off some crazy thing that the ship shouldn't be able to handle because of the kind of ship it is, because of how big and weird it is. But somehow you pull it off.
And Bishop just Bishop just grabs Vi and just, like, holds her close to his chest. He's like, "All right, we got this." And then waits for Susha to either kill us or save us.
You see me, like, pop open the container with the special guard thing. I hope this works. and I have Oofy in the other hand. And I'm just like, yeah.
I'm glad you're holding on to me while you're being a lightning rod. That's great.
What?
Yep. Okay, cool. So yeah, 5. Yep, you take a stress.
You're my
so
closest friend here.
Basically, you turn your body into a catalyst for the way.
Yeah.
And yeah, you, like, it doesn't hurt you a lot. And you're pretty sure it's because it's obviously not that the goddess is in the rod, but because of that weirdness of way it had in it.
That's what I'm using.
Yeah, exactly. You tap into that and just unleash it. And yeah, you just, like, make a weird shockwave of way energy that is, like, everybody, like, feels. Like in your inside, everyone feels it inside. It's a weird feeling that you get as, like, this wave shockwave rips out, and then out of, like, the portholes,
I like to make a quick scene. You see, like, a scene between the ghost crew that's there and, like, me in the astral plane, and I make a promise to them I'll come back to them when I'm stronger. Well, no one deserves purgatory.
Yeah,
but this is a mission for another day.
So I think the last. Do we get the slow mo? Everything is frozen, like at the end of source code.
Yeah, this weird way shockwave, like, bursts out, and I think it causes everyone to, like, black out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then slowly, like, you start to wake up. Like, kind of all around the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And then
21 conscious to be like, I don't know what I saw.
I don't can we have gone to halt or something? Can we just, like, wake up and halt?
You're supposed to be going to Breck.
I know.
No, that would be amazing if we end up in the wrong system.
So you guys,
there's no connection there. That would be amazing.
So you guys, like, slowly come to. And Vi's like pangolin body is kind of just, like, pushing on Bishop's chest, like, hey.
Bishop,
hey.
Like, reaches up and like pats her and is like,
you okay?
Am I in hell? Did I die already?
Well, I don't Well, that's a... I'm here, so I don't know if I can do that. So, maybe.
You have a soul. It's okay.
Okay, thank you.
I still got Oofy in my hand, and I'm like, still... I'm kind of crying.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's
so like Bishop, that. Like, sits up and looks at his instruments. It's just like, where the fuck are we?
You see your, like, your instruments aren't really saying anything, but that's fairly normal for warping. Like, cause like, they
are
don't.
But are we like in warp?
Right. Yeah. You see your readings and it's like, okay, there's not really much, like the ship's fine. And then you look out through like your portholes and like your like main thing. And you see that weirdness of like a warp tunnel that you're going through.
I think Bishop just looks at it for a second. It's just like, holy fuck, we did it.
Yes.
I knew you had it in you, Bishop.
And then the balanced breakfast crew, like, starts to come around, too. And, like, Tony, like, kind of, like, pushes himself off a console, like, holy hell.
Now let's see if they age 20 years in 10 seconds.
No, they don't.
See me put...
No, Bishop Lee says that. He's like, I'm legitimately curious.
Oh, like, and I think, like, Tony, like, that... And then he realizes he has no idea if that would happen or not. And so he just, like, looks down at his body and then, like, there's, like, silence for, like, 10 seconds and, like, nothing happens. And I was like, okay.
I think we're good.
Okay.
I think we're good. And then Bishop just, like, picks up the pangolin and just, like, holds her up and then just, like, kisses her and, like, sets her back on his shoulder.
You see me put Oopy Deck down and I kind of put away my dark rod of, I'm going to call it the dark rod. And now it has like a negative energy like thing going on. Can I get that? Like,
sure. Yeah. It's it. Yeah.
Because it's from a pocket dimension. I put it back in this little thing.
Yep. You have a weird way rod. Awesome.
Weird way rod is like a really like sexual band. You
know? Right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Or like a weird sex.
So, you guys like kind of come to check everything is okay, and then. Kind of very suddenly come out of warp space. And immediately around you, you see a gate and like ships lined up to enter it. And like you kind of come out next to another ship, like as if you both had exited this at the same time. And immediately like ship alarms are like proximity warning, because not because they're going to hit you, but because you guys are like this far away in space.
Yeah.
So you're like, oh shit. And just like pull away. You get a,
Oh, wait a minute. I put up a way bubble around Casper to make sure they can't detect them.
Oh, yeah. Casper's fine.
Feels like
I'm like, instantly like, bubble.
Yeah. Casper's fine. Casper woke up with the rest of the other crew. No,
because the reason they got shot because they detected Casper. I'm making sure Waywatcher can't detect them this time around.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense. Yes.
I'm like, we don't need
that feels like a zero stress flash.
Oh, totally. I think like you get like a like you don't get a full on hail from the other ship, but you get like hey, what the fuck, man? Like a honk, basically the space equivalent, the space equivalent of like a dun dun, like why'd you cut me off kind of thing.
I think Bishop just presses the button and just says, motherfucker, this is Bishop Brigginson, and I'm not dead. Fuck you. And then just hangs up.
Like, we cut to the other ship, and it's just like a crew of like a ragtag, another similar ragtag crew, and like, who the fuck is that? Like, I don't know. Are we supposed to know?
You know, and you see the armor guy that's the bounty hunter. Like, yeah, I know that guy. My Spanish pups.
Perfect.
And yeah, so we see you guys floating off. When your scanners start coming to and like being like and like picking back up onto like the network, you guys are in IOTA. So
where
like
we started from.
Yeah, you like basically jumped and then jumped.
Neat.
And you get a ping from I forgot what their ship is called.
That is the ghost ship.
Right, yeah, it's the ghost ship. The skeleton key. Their ship's called the skeleton key. You got a ping from the skeleton key, like, to, like, open a comms.
Yeah.
Bishop opens comms.
Like, and then it's, It's like it's Cervantes, the ghost that you had made this arrangement with.
Right.
And like, hello, magic dance.
Aye, aye.
Are you all okay?
Yeah, cargo.
How long have we been gone?
Yes. Okay, one at a time.
We have the cargo. How long have we been in warp?
So you got them?
We have the cargo. How long have we been in warp?
And he like we hear him like shout something off like away from the mic, and then we hear like a bunch of like yeah, all right, kind of thing.
It's like Muppets.
Yeah, just because like yeah. And then he like
skeleton key. How copy?
We last saw you 6 months ago.
Okay, that's not too bad. They were in there for 20 years on their side, and we were in there for about an hour. I'll call that a win.
Oh my god.
I think it was probably more like 5 hours, but you know.
Something. Whatever. How math is weird.
Time math.
Time math, exactly.
We got some crazy shit on our computers. And we got your people approaching to make exchange.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we you guys meet up. Casper goes over. We see like someone in like a power suit like walk over and like give him a hug and like bring him back onto the ship. And then some drones are carrying the cargo onto the skeleton key.
They carry the unconscious guy over because I'm making sure he stays sedated. The ride by. I'm keeping this.
Yeah. What are we doing with the rest of the crew for that?
Starship? Yeah, I think Tony probably just asked you guys, like, if you could just anywhere, just drop us off. We'll try to figure it out. But I mean, we're good now. Apparently, if it's only been 6 months in out here, then our bank account should still work. So,
well, 7 months for y'all.
Oh yay! That's so because
it was
so much
one
more.
Month that before we left, and then 7 months, 6 more months.
So
months,
but,
anyway.
And then
I mean, we'll agree to drop him off at some.
Yeah, yeah. Before you guys leave the skeleton key, Cervantes like walks over to Ophi with like a cred thing, hands it over, and like thank you so much for rescuing them and Casper, and I don't know how you guys did it, but you did it.
There was a lot of solving for one.
We have a good pilot.
Okay, and that means something to you, but it means nothing to him, and so it was just like, sure.
Yeah, like Ophi was gonna say something, but they both just spouted some nonsense, so they just kind of like shrug their gel shoulders. And
talk to Casper, he'll fill you in.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, sounds good. I'm sure he'll have a lot to tell us. Thank you again. Hopefully, see you later.
Much appreciated.
Yep, and then so you guys head
as
off.
They take the 10 creds.
Yeah. And then do you split that up?
Yeah, probably. Okay. I mean, so we probably like do 2 a piece, and then 2 to the crew, 2
sure.
to the ship. Yeah.
Yeah.
Where is the Urbot Conclave or whatever they're called?
Oh, yeah. I think it's just the Conclave. Yeah, Conclave 01. Yeah. Now that you guys are back in, like. You kind of like you did the exchange and you kind of have like another moment to yourselves. You check your messages and stuff and like oh shit, I have six months worth of unread email, and like you probably filter out all the worthless stuff. Bishop, you have a message from Ara Ini.
Opens it.
Mm-hmm. It opens up. It's a video thing, and you see It's like a video, a recorded video message.
She's 6 months pregnant.
No, she's 12.
And a robot. Yes.
So yeah, like you see Ara Ini saying like, hey, it's been a while. I sent you a thing a couple months ago, and now another. I've sent you several messages. I hope you're not dead. Let me know if you're dead. I have something really big for you.
Bishop like sends a reply.
Yeah. It's like,
Hi, this is Bishop. Say hi, Vi. And he points the camera at Vi, who's like floating there.
Yeah.
Like points it back at him. We've been between warp gates for about 6 months, but it was about 5 hours for us. It's really complicated. There's a lot of strange theoretical math that doesn't work. We're not dead. You're awesome. Where are you located yet? We're on your way.
Uh-huh.
We're on our way. It doesn't matter. I'm really excited to not be dead. So I'm just having a hard time saying things.
Mm-hmm.
And then he hangs up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
and then he calls back immediately. He's like, bye. And he hangs
up. Yeah, well, yeah.
I do want to ask Bishop for some side help, because I want to turn this into a Nate's Darksaber.
Bishop is not the person to ask for that.
I thought, but you have Rig that should help with the hard part. Like, I'm going to come up with this.
Well, so
he can definitely help you like make something, but
so yeah, I think what here. Let's just do this. So, we see you guys kind of getting taken care of stuff. We see you like at a space station, kind of like shaking hands with everybody, the crew, mm-hmm. and the balance breakfast takes off, and you guys like go up. And float off, and then we like fade, and basically like
10 months later or whatever.
Well, I'm gonna give you guys like a vignette or a thing for you guys to say what has happened, like gotcha. Or like how you guys have ended up or whatever. Like, Bishop, I'll text you what Arini is going to do when you go see her, and then you can tell me what your scene will be.
Sure. Send me. Send me your sweet words. Lily.
Da, 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 da. Never gonna dance again. Cause you bought Sar. You bought Sar so weird right now. I about to become a Doctor Jedi Immortal Gem whatever person. And I'm gonna have a Force lightsaber.
So that's the thing.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. So who wants to? Anyone want to go first?
Kelsa.
So with our payout, I got myself a full bar of stash. So, I think this is just like a shot of like. Ophi basking in her new wealth, so to speak.
Yeah.
You know,
are you just sitting in a golden bathtub this time?
Yes, definitely.
Yep.
Definitely a golden bathtub, and also like a new higher quality little vest that they wear.
Uh-huh.
You know, stuff like that. Like just like everything in the magic dance like looks better, cleaner, newer. Like just mm-hmm. basically.
Sure. Sure.
Generally just basking in the, like, we just got 10 creds. It's a party.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Cool.
That kind of life. They don't really have, they have simple needs. So there's a golden bathtub for them to relax in. And then there's another golden bathtub that is just filled with candy.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a golden toilet for me to throw up in from when he hits those sick G's.
Mm-hmm. Obviously.
Yeah. So yeah, so Ophi's thing is just them relaxing with their newfound wealth.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
How about Bishop or Susha?
Let's have Susha go first.
Yeah, okay. So you see Susha like, I guess eventually get that space rod turned into a Nihilite Darksaber, and mm-hmm. eventually I get that purple heart put into me.
Oh yeah, yeah. So we see you. Sometime later, and then we for some reason it's showing your chest, and we see this like weird green glow coming out of this like stone in your chest because you like were able to get into the mendicants, and then yeah, like how do we see your weird lightsaber thing?
Basically, it looks like the Darksaber that the Mandalorians had.
Mm.
Like,
awesome. Are you like cutting something in half just to like show it off to Bishop?
Yeah, I show it to Bishop, like, yeah, it takes a lot of, this is definitely new, because you kind of see my chest kind of open with the new glow thing.
Right. Like, awesome. Cool, cool.
I never expect me to be here.
Badass.
That's awesome, yeah. Got a lightsaber and a fake heart that lets you stay alive through anything. Great.
So, okay.
Looking good.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we do it like a really tight zoom of Bishop and Susha in tuxedos or tuxedo looking outfits.
Okay.
You know what the best thing about it? You're actually giving me advice on picking up ladies because I'm actually like, you know what? Life is short, even though I'm immortal.
So Bishop is like a dusting of bow tie and just like not having a good time of it. And he like looks over
by and help him.
So like, reach over and help him. And he's like, man, I'm nervous. Oh, this is scary. I've never done anything like this before.
You got this, man. You're the best goddamn pilot in the universe. No, you let anybody tell you that way.
Thank you. And he like gives you a hug and then he like looks over at Ophi, who is standing like up on like a raised platform, and is like, you remember like everything you're supposed to do, right?
And Ophi has like a digital bow tie. He has a digital bow tie.
You remember?
So, Ophi definitely is wearing like the vest is like you would have a suit vest.
Mm-hmm.
And it like has tails off of it, even though it doesn't have any sleeves. clearly like a digital.
And so the camera's like, just been on them, and then we like the music, da da da. The like the here comes the bride fades in, and we slowly pan over to see like a bunch of like NPCs from throughout the show, like sitting in like unfolding chairs.
Yeah, it's
like unfolding chairs in like the mess. And then at the end of like the chairs, we have Ara Eni holding the hand of a like adult looking human woman. Can you describe what Vi's new body looks like?
So I think it's like she has like kind of like shoulder length dark hair. Her eyes are like kind of like yours in that like she can like do stuff with them, like change the color or like glow a little bit, so they're like glowing a little bit. They're glowing like a light glowing green a little bit.
I think Bishop sees her, and just to add to the animatus, his eyes go pink for just a second and then go back to their blue.
She's wearing a basically a sci-fi wedding dress. So there's like a weird like asymmetrical cut to it.
It orbits out at a weird angle.
The
way it could fabrically stand up that way.
Right. Yeah. There's like weird stuff like floating off of it. Like the accessories are. There's not like a long tail. There's like a long like a thing floating behind her. It's like totally weird in anime sci-fi. So and yeah, we see her. She looks up at you like. Blushes a little bit, and then they start to walk down.
Bishop like awkwardly laughs because he's like, "Oh God, I'm terrified. What am I doing?"
Yeah, she walks up. Arani like walks up with her, and then yeah, she like stands in front of you, and then the two of you are in front of Ophi, and like
Bishop just like leans in and is like, "You know, my mom's gonna kill us, right?"
She kills a lot of people, so.
She really does. I think we'll be fine. I love you.
I love you too.
All right, Captain. Let's light this candle.
I don't want to go into a long rant in my Ophi voice, but there definitely is like a 5-minute preamble before like we actually get to anything. And this was not actually like in the prepared materials that Bishop provided, it was like
dearly beloved, we are gathered here today.
No, it's like as the captain of this ship, I can complete this marriage in the name of the Commonwealth. If you both agree as consenting adults, like that's like the bare minimum legality to perform the marriage.
Yeah.
And instead, there's like a 5-minute preamble about how.
Oh yeah.
How much of an asshole Bishop is.
Oh yeah.
Like it sounds like at first it sounds like she's gonna like talk about how like the love between the couples or whatever, but like very quickly it just degrades into her like bad mouthing Bishop and like eyeballing like they just like they their face is like turned directly to Vi, and then eventually gets to the end is like, are you sure you know what you're getting into?
Yeah, I do.
Well, side note, how big did our pet get?
Oh, yeah. Zoinks. Yes. Oh, oh.
On top of this giant lizard.
No, no. Oh, I think there's a point, and then, like, Ophi, and then it's like, okay, may we have the rings? And then giant lizard just barrels down the center, who's now, like, the size of, like, a mastiff.
Yeah.
And just barrels down. And, like, has rings hanging off, like, on, like, a weird necklace thing.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, you could take them out and put them on.
And they're like weird, like sci-fi holographic, like chipset rings.
Yeah, yeah.
Totally.
We like put those on.
Yeah, and then Ophi concludes with marriage is now officially legal anywhere.
Bishop and Vi are already making out.
Yeah, like there's like this whole like legal disclaimer at the end that has to be read, like, because this is stupid, you know, corporate overlord future, whatever.
Right. No, this marriage is not recognized in sectors 242.
Yeah, exactly. It's like everywhere right. except blah blah blah, or like all planets under the common
right under the under hegemonic rule are like
yeah.
This marriage is not recognized if you violate the safety protocols of a warp gate or something.
Yes, it's weird bullshit. Yeah, and then we see everybody like clapping and.
As Ophi's reading that, Bishop has just put her into a princess carry and mm-hmm. has just carried her into the bridge of the ship.
Yeah.
And just locked the door.
Uh huh. Excellent. Yeah, so we see that everybody's clapping. Everybody's like having a good time. And then we like fade away. Michael, do you care if I reveal it?
Yeah, let's.
Okay,
let's,
I got
well.
It.
I hinted at it a bunch.
So. Okay, because I want to. I was like, so.
Do I call her or does she call me?
No. There's
There's another thing.
There's another thing. So we enter into like basically like a big ass private office.
Uh-huh.
Of like Think like the Oval Office, but like if it were on
a
Coruscant.
A billion times more opulent and sci-fi.
Yeah. Like the Oval Office, if it were like basically like Coruscant from Star Wars, whoever's in charge of that planet has a version of the Oval Office, and it's just huge and like opulent. It's like fancy and like weird and sci-fi. There's a giant staircase that leads up to like the actual part of where the office is. Like it's all the same room though. There's like columns and like. Hollow sculptures going up the entire staircase and around the thing. There's like moving paintings on different spaces. It's like an art gallery mixed with an office mixed with like a bar. There's like it's a whole thing. Like it's almost like a house in an office essentially. And we see like this huge ass like very very nice wood desk. And like a woman.
Expensive.
Oh yeah. Like. You could probably buy a small planet with what this desk costs, kind of thing. Mm-hmm. We see a woman.
Beautiful gold leaf inlay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We see a woman, like, sitting at it with, like, a bunch of, like, hollow displays in front of her. And she is just, like she's in, like an annoyed pose, like, where she's, like, kind of, like, touched, like this, where she's, like, thinking, but also, like, there's, like, stress lines on her face because she's, like, annoyed about something. And we see she's wearing a very, like a green gown. And then she has like a, no, she wouldn't have, no, yeah, it's just like super, super nice green gown.
It's probably got actual emeralds in it.
Oh yeah.
Like actual, it's like emeralds that have been extruded out into thread.
Uh-huh.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
And then.
Emerald nanotube dress.
Yeah. And then we see like on her desk like a small like hollow person appears, and then it's like, "Ma'am, we've confirmed the rumors," and she just like looks at it, the hologram like visibly goes like, "Mako has been assassinated." And she, like, nods, and then, like, that means all of your children have been killed, ma'am. And she just, like, leans back in the chair and, like, says, not all of them. And then, like, reaches over and, like picks up a
like an actual photograph.
Yeah. Well, no, it's like she reaches into like her like a secret compartment of her desk and pulls out like it's like there's like a little secret compartment where it's like a photograph and like a weirdly physical phone. Like it's almost like if sure. if you saw like a bar like a regular cell phone from now. And we see like a like at, like she like picks up the picture and it's her with a Kai man or like a masculine looking Kai and she's holding a child with like a white like light like slightly lit hair very blue eyes and like a dark skin and then she like as she picks up the phone and like dials a number and puts the phone up to her ear. And then we cut back to the magic dance. I think we see Vi like up on a console with Bishop and her like making out.
Mm-hmm.
And then like,
Motherfucker, what do you want?
Hello, son.
Oh shit. Hi, mom.
You see me just look over like, mom. I'm like, taking a drink.
Because that's the only word that like comes through from the other room when they're out. Yeah, it's great.
I'm well, more sensitive now.
I'm like, that was quick. So married.
And yeah, that's Magic Dance.
That was a fun show, guys.
That was a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun. This is a fantastic game. I love this game.
I think I like Scum and Villainy a little bit more than I like Blades.
Oh, Blades! We played a couple Blade games, so it's kind of like we know what to expect. On this one, we didn't really know what to expect because there was so many genres put into it.
I love that this is happening now. Like basically Blades is getting the Apocalypse World treatment where it's like, okay, someone made this fantastic thing. Let's pull out the core and then attach different stuff onto it. And now we're getting these other things like Band of Blades, Girl by Moonlight, Scum and Villainy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love seeing that.
As a general rule, works really well.
Oh yeah, yeah. Just the core of it is totally solid. And just when you add on this extra fictional stuff of like being space opera or Dungeoneers or Magical Girls or whatever, like it's built around a very solid core, which totally works. Andrew Comedian Crow is making one. It's called Girl by Moonlight.
I would love to play that.
Oh my gosh,
it's so good. And I have played a one shot of it and I've ran a one shot of it and it is really amazingly good.
I love me some Sailor Moon.
They do some really good stuff with it too, like the conflict mechanics are different. Like
yeah.
Are you a high school girl or a college girl?
Well, you can. It's
your choice.
Yeah. You choose it. There's different playbooks. There's different There's crew books for the different kinds of magical girls, and then you have yourselves your own playbooks. And then the way you do things in it is, they take the Blade stuff and move it around, and it's very good.
I think it's very. I'm excited to sit down and finally play it.
Me too.
I've read a little bit of it, and it looks great.
Mm-hmm. Anything else you guys want to say about the game / this show / stuff?
I really had a good time playing Ophi. I really had a good time. I think that the whole cast, the crew of the ship, really had a really good dynamic. We had some pretty solid characters that each had their own extremes that pulled in different directions.
Mm-hmm.
But no one, like, I don't feel like anyone pulled too far in one direction. We were pulling kind of equally. Mm-hmm. To get some interesting stuff in there.
I was talking to Kels about this when the show first started. I fall really naturally into the Lancer role. For those of you who don't know what five-man band is, the Lancer is the character that could be the second in command, but isn't the second in command for whatever reason, and bugs the leader. And it's like challenging the leader constantly to A, like force them to do things differently or B, encourage them to improve. Right, yeah. And that's just, whenever I'm a PC, that's just where I fall naturally.
And I'm usually the boss's best friend.
Okay, so in five man band, there's the leader, the lancer, the smart guy, the big guy, and the heart. And in four man bands, it gets a little wonky. I would probably argue that Vi was the heart.
I would see that in this
particular game. So Vi's the heart. Floor's the big guy. Susha's the smart guy in this case. Ophi's the leader. Bishop's the lancer. Mm-hmm.
Because when I see weird stuff, I'm like, I think I could do something for that. Because eventually, I'm gonna have that super weapon for Flora. we could just level groups.
Yeah, yeah.
It's an interesting and that narrative works really well in storytelling.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And I think is why the animated version of Teen Titans worked so well, because you had basically in that dynamic you had the relationship with between Robin and Cyborg being the leader lancer.
Yeah.
And that made for some really like compelling story arcs.
Starfire is the best.
Starfire is hands down the heart of that show.
Oh yeah.
It's just like, I love her speech pattern.
Mm-hmm.
I do not understand this get real. and the thing about, I know people hail Teen Titan Go, but they do have some good times, like when she had the T-Pain voice. It's like, will we know Uncle no more? I'm like, and then when she got the voice of a teenage like high school girl, and I just love Raven's response. It's like, why are you talking now like that? How are you talking like that? Why are you tripping, dog?
It is a good like, I would totally play a superhero Blades hack if I could be Teen Titans.
That would be fun.
I'm not sure where it's at.
I'm sure that exists.
I'm not sure where it's at, but I think it was Sage, the co-creator of Dungeon World, was working on one for basically making like low-level supervillains.
Ooh.
So like like Thunderbolts in Justice League, superior foes of Spider-Man. Like it was kind of like a
kind of dynamic.
Yeah, like all, basically the premise, like all the huge villains and superheroes are off doing huge shit. You're in a big ass city with not a lot of heroes and not a lot of cops, and it's open season.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds really good.
But once in a while, you have to have like one like maybe A class villain to drop down.
Oh no, yeah. That was
Every once in a while, an actual hero shows up and kicks your ass.
Right. Yeah. Like every once in a while, Superman just comes down. And it's like, oh well, okay, I surrender. Like. Yeah, like you're basically like C-level, like, I'm
right?
Blanking on actual like comic ones, but like, yeah, it sounds really cool.
Let me guess, basically what the...
Like Spider-Man villains, kind of.
Like, it was like Hero for Hire kind of shenanigan. Like,
yeah.
Heroes for Hire is such a good comic.
I love Heroes for Hire. Like, me personally, I like Iron Fist, because he's so powerful, but yet, you know, he still could be sidelined just
I think my favorite thing about Heroes for Hire is how many not white heroes there are in Heroes for Hire.
There's a lot of different people with different power. That's why I like it.
That's cool.
I am looking forward to the new mutants.
Mm-hmm. Because
I'm like Magpie. I love her as a character. It's
and Hulu's making a thing of Runaways, which apparently is supposed to be really good.
Yeah.
Because
X-Men have so many like side mutants that are great, but everybody just want to see the main.
Yeah, girl. Everyone's like Wolverine. It's like, well, what about this person?
I'm excited Armor for the
is amazing character.
Armor's so like, cool.
It's so cool. Or Jolt, the one like she kind of has super speed, but she can't quite control it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm excited for? I'm excited for whenever. And I know there's a sort of like it in the works, but I don't think it really goes far enough. I'm excited for whenever they make the Vinland Saga of Blades hacks. Not Vinland Saga, Saga of the Icelanders.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Blades hacks. Cause I would, you know what I would really love to see? I would love to see like a 1920s, 30s bootlegger hack. Like, if you were to take Bootlegger's Hack,
working on that.
I would play the shit out of that game. I'm not even kidding.
I think that might be one of the things from the Kickstarter. I'm not entirely sure.
I would also play the shit out of The Regiment if it was a Blades Hack. I'm excited for the potential of this system.
Yeah, yeah.
Odds are, when I finish all the projects I'm working on, I'm going to start on the Blades Hack because it's the thing to do.
It's totally. It's so good.
Mechanically, the circle is done. I just need the money to get layouts finished.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is the most expensive part of writing a game.
Right.
So yeah.
Awesome. Well, I believe that is that. So, let's do our last shout-outs. Michael, how about you start us off?
Hello, everyone. I'm Michael, or MTO All Pro on Twitter, MTO2424, basically everywhere else. I designed The Circle, which is a crazy game about people that have magical powers that don't fully understand them. It is in late stages of development. I'm just doing fiction writing and layouts on it. And then I'm going to try to make it available sooner rather than later. Thank you so much for watching this show, if you're watching it live or in the VODs. This has been a lot of fun. I know it has not been the most consistent show, but this has been one of the more fun shows I've got to be a player in, hands down. Because the world is great, the group is great, and Bishop is a crazy bastard. I love him. And now he's going to go become the hegemon, I think.
Something, I guess,
or get assassinated. Probably get assassinated.
Whatever.
What are you talking about? You have your Jedi bro to back you up.
Right.
Yeah, that's immortal. Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Well, if he does, there's going to definitely be like an Urbrot's rights bill that ends up on his desk pretty quick. So, thank you for coming out. Thanks, you, Lily, for running this. I know you have taken the time to continue running these shows during a relatively complex time in your life.
You know, whatever.
And thank you so much for doing that for us. Thank you, Kelsa, Smooth Mage, and Liz, even though they are not here, for being on cast with me, because it was a lot of fun.
Yeah, awesome. We appreciate you bringing on. Yeah. Kelsa, how about you?
Hey everybody, I'm Kelsa. You can find me on the internet on Twitter at Kelsa, here on Twitch and on YouTube. It's /KelsaDelphi, KelsaDelphi. Mostly what I do is play role-playing games on the internet. Obviously, I've been part of Magic Dance this entire time, and I'm sad to see it go, but I think this is a pretty good ending. As far as things go,
we're not going to have a more difficult challenge than what we just had. Like, let's be honest.
I mean,
like, the stakes are never going to be higher than breaking the rules of reality.
We still got the gate. What's behind the gate? Is it going to be more Pennyworths? Is it going to be an army of Pennyworths?
Okay, yeah. we open it up and the Rachni come out.
Yeah.
We all die.
That's going
to
be
fun. Then we have to ascend the Krogans and things just get complicated.
The whole thing.
Well, in the background, just like, Force Strike.
Yeah. Anyway, you can find me on the internet playing role-playing games. Follow me on Twitter. I always tweet when I'm going down live on different shows. I was host on my own channel on Twitch as well. I've been trying to curate all of the shows that I've been on my YouTube page, but that is still a work in progress.
There's a lot.
There are a lot. I've done this for 2 years now, being on people's shows weekly.
And you don't half-ass the number of shows you're on either.
No, I don't. with the end of Magic Dance, it's going to be dropping down to 3 shows a week.
But that's the lowest you've had in as long as I've known you.
That's pretty true. I mean, it was consistently like 5 or 6 for a while.
Mm-hmm. Four is the lowest you've gotten until like right now, which is kind of crazy.
So yeah, you can find out more about all my shows. I'm also on the other show on Liz's channel, which is Longfall, which is my personal favorite show.
I have a lot of fun running that show.
Mm-hmm.
I'm GM for that, by the way.
Yes. there's also a show on Friday nights on my own channel called Harvest Valley, which is a Burning Wheel game, with the kind of flavor of Stardew Valley or Harvest Moon. It's been going pretty good. We had a show last night, and I'm really liking the direction.
Sam just joined that, didn't he?
We've going. Yeah.
Awesome.
So, then tonight, also every Saturday night, I am over on AP Gaming Reels channel for some D&D. We're playing 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons, and plus some kingdom building bullshit, but, you know, that's fine.
Hey, Kingmaker.
I have a lot of fun playing it, regardless, so that's me. That's my things. I do a lot of things.
Awesome. Well, thank you also for being on. Always happy to have you on the show.
It was fun having you as my GM.
Mm-hmm. And Dom, Smooth Mage, how about you finish off?
I forgot to mention I'm starting a Pony Finder, Ponies in Space!
Oh, God.
On Monday with a new Starfinder system.
Oh, my gosh.
So that's going to be fun. Which is terrible because I already, in my other game that I used to play about a month ago, I was Amuro the White Knight and I had a Fluttershy and a Gundam outfit. So I don't know what to do with this one. It's like, I think I'm going to pick a Pony Shepherd just to cover that. It's silly.
Oh my gosh.
I don't even watch My Little Pony anymore, but I still like the memes.
Pony Finder is, I feel like the experience of playing Pony Finder would be about like shooting LSD, crack cocaine in liquid form, and horse tranquilizer into your arm and just going for a ride.
Well, the thing about it, the guy who created Pony Finder is one of my friends, David Silver. And he's like, I'm about to put a group together and I need people that play along well and cope well. It's like, you're the first one I picked. And I was like, you know what? I'm ready to do this. Put me in the game, coach. And then the first thing I asked is, do we have a healer? Because if we need a healer, I'll be your healer.
You love being the healer. Like, that's your, like, jam.
Well, it's more like it needs to be done. Mm-hmm. And I might as well have fun with it.
I just like being the fiction hound. That's my favorite part.
Support. And I just like reloaded the Blood Bowl website, the guy that I need to lose lost just now recently. So it's like, yes, on my half, I'm leading in the polls. Now I just have to win at least two of my next two, three games, and I'm fine. Well, technically, I just have to win one of my next three games because I'm safe for the playoffs. But, you know, I'd like to have a little bit more cushion.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody hates my Amazon. They keep taking tackle, and their guys with tackle keeps dying because, you know, you should be taking block first before you take tackle. Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Well, also very glad to have you on the show, Dom. You're super cool. And
no, I love playing with y'all. Hope y'all, we all make another game. Think of me.
Awesome.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So thank you again for hanging out with us and watching Magic Dance as a whole thing. Sad that it has to end early, but like we brought it to a pretty good close. I like doing that with shows and stuff, like doing a last big final thing and then having the cast do like,
this felt
where
like
are they
really,
now?
This felt like a really organic place to end it.
It did. Yeah.
I think so too.
Yeah. I didn't feel, it wasn't too forced. It wasn't too big of us like, just like, oh, nope, just cut it off. It did a last big mission and then
I like how
big payout.
Our stuff. Like the last one was like a family dinner.
Yeah. Yeah.
A wedding. Uh-huh. I like it.
Yeah, yeah.
A phone call from mom.
Yep.
I'm just like Force Awakens, like mom.
I am very much a fan of the movie style. Oh, everything returns to normalcy until it doesn't.
Uh-huh. I just like letting it, like having everybody do like, it's not mechanized. It's not a thing. It's just like, okay, tell me where you end up. Kind of like endings like that, like we did with Smooth Criminals, like we've done with this, we've done for other games. I really like that of like, okay, let's set the game aside now that we finish things and like fictionally, tell me where you are and like give us a little scene. Like I like that a lot. So I'm glad we did it here, and so right now Wednesdays we have Longfall. I'm gonna do getting now that I have my new overlays and stuff, and I'm getting ready to do some more video gamey things. Probably like, I'll probably do Magic Gathering now that I'm getting into that. Destiny, blah blah blah, all the stuff.
If you will let me know when you're playing, I will learn you.
Excellent, excellent, very good. We have that. We have Longfall. After Longfall, which has like maybe 5-6 weeks left, we'll be jumping into something else. Not entirely sure when that's going to be starting. We have the crew and stuff together, but we're getting that around. And then with this ending, I might start up something else. Yeah, if you keep on the Twitter, on the Twitch, all that stuff, you'll be able to see all that when we get it figured out. So thank you again. Have an awesome night. Huh?
Hey, Lily. Lily, Lily.
Yeah?
You should GM the circle. I desperately need someone to playtest the GM side besides Lise. Uh-huh.
I'm sorry, but I need one of y'all to run a 5e game if I could play with it with y'all, because I kind of want to play a 5e game with Kelsa and MTO just to get the feel of it.
I feel like it would be violent.
It's going to be violent, but it's going to be fun violent.
Awesome. If someone have a slot open up in a 5e game, I will let you know, I promise.
Mm-hmm. I would love cool. to play
with yep, good, good, good. So, thank you again. I hope you all have a great night, and hopefully we'll see you around the channel and around these folks' channels, too. Bye-bye.
Bye. Mm-hmm.